So at Inventus, we've raised our third fund now, which we are investing out of. This is an India-dedicated fund, unlike the previous two, which were overseas funds. And this fund is dedicated to make investments in India. Inventus India is a Series A investor. We invest typically 5 to 15 crores in $2 to $5 million Series A rounds. Focus is technology with a broad definition. So internet, mobile, software, IoT, machine learning, blockchain-based apps, these are some of the things that we do. The fund is a 325 crore fund, which has got oversubscribed, but we have the green shoe option and would be open till either we hit the green shoe limit or till October of this year, whichever is earlier. We intend to do maybe 15, 16 investments. Typically at Series A, we do $1 million to $3 million in $2 to $5 million rounds. We lead all our investments, but we bring in other co-investors to co-invest alongside us. Some of the newer areas that we hadn't done before, which we've actually done out of this fund in the early investments, we've done some hardware companies. Our belief is that IoT is going to be a big area for Indian startups if you take a long-term 10-15-year view. So we've made a few investments in that space, which therefore necessarily mean hardware companies. One is in an accessory for two-wheeler helmets, going on to probably building a smart helmet in a few years' time. And the other is in the gaming area, where it's a combination of augmented reality as well as physical building blocks too, for building educational games. We've also done a blockchain-based startup as part of this fund, so that's another new area. Given our view that blockchain could become mainstream in 5 to 8 years' time, this is a 10-year life fund, so we have a long time, and the first close just happened in October 2018. So we have a lot of time for our investments to gestate and grow. And therefore, we're actively looking at areas that may even need a longer gestation period. So our previous two funds were also 10-year funds. So it's not that we suddenly looked at a 10-year fund. It is driven by a strong belief that early stage startups, and we are an early stage investor, we are a Series A investor, we are not coming in at B, C, or where startups have matured. It takes time to build companies. It takes time in India to get your first few customers, to perfect the product, then scale, to grow. And if you need a profitable exit, investors need time for those companies to be around and scale for a while. Exits are hard in India. And if you have shorter life funds, you will find yourself making premature exits, which will not give the best returns to investors. Having said that, I'll also add that, you know, we all talk in venture capital of a hockey stick. And my belief, which I've been articulating for some time now, is the hockey stick is fallen in India. So it's not a vertical hockey stick, it's a horizontal hockey stick. So there's a long period where startups grow slowly and then they take off. And that's why also you need a longer gestation period. For every rupee we invest in the Series A round, we have 1.5 rupees to 2 rupees reserved for follow-ons. So when I talk of us being Series A investors, I mean that our initial entry into the company will be at Series A, but we will almost always participate in the B and most likely in the C at least as well. So we do support our companies in their next rounds, and we have substantial reserves to support them for the follow-on rounds. This is an opportunistic business. So while bulk of our investments, 80-90% would be Series A, opportunistically, if there's a great entrepreneur who happens to have raised Series A, but is raising a Series B that fits our sweet spot of $1 million to $3 million from our side, we would do it. And a classic example is Policy Bazaar. Actually, 6.5 years ago, we did a Series B in that company. And today it's, you know, a great success. And the blockchain-based company we've done is actually a seed company. We've done 300K into that company in a 500K round. So that's early for us, but we really like the entrepreneur. And as I said, blockchain is a space that we think could become mainstream in 5 to 8 years. If it does, this company has a great chance of being a huge success. I think partly I attribute it to my partner Parag, just doesn't like lending, but more importantly, and I think he has valid reasons, this is not a tech-driven issue. It's a credit risk understanding. And at this firm, at our firm, we believe we have no understanding or capability to understand credit risks. And that's one of the reasons we stayed away and will stay away from online lending. So typically in venture capital, you don't say no to anything. But I think this credit risk business, we've said no to. I think we don't follow the fashion of the day. We are not herd mentality investors. This philosophy is driven by the fact that we have been investing for a very long time. Parag's been an investor for 25 years. I myself have been an investor for almost 18 years. We've seen multiple cycles of booms and busts. And I think seeing cycles of boom and bust gives you a perspective that is very hard to get if you haven't seen a bust, and a bust specifically. So collectively, we've seen the 99-2000 boom and bust. We've seen the 2007-8 and then 9 boom and bust. We've seen the 14-15 boom and a slight bust. And I think for us, following the herd, chasing fads is something that we just don't do. We are not top-down investors. We don't say that we should do a hyperlocal or 3 hyperlocal companies, 2 fintech companies, 3 food tech companies and all that stuff. We are very clear that we will back good entrepreneurs in the space that we have defined for ourselves. So we won't stray out of technology. That's again something very clear to us. In that space, whether it's blockchain, IoT, machine learning based applications, SaaS, internet, mobile, good entrepreneurs will find backing from us. So this unicorn is a myth again. What is the sanctity of $1 billion? Who understands dollars here in India? And what is a billion? To me, 100 crores is a big milestone. 1,000 crores is a big milestone. One of the biggest cash exits of its time, Redbus, we were early investors in that company. And that was an exit that took place in 2013. It gave stellar returns for us, for our investors. Policy Bazaar is another company that, is on its way to give stellar returns to our investors. We got in at low double-digit valuations. Today, I can't count the number of digits in its valuation. So, there are many breakout successes that we've had. So I think it's a good time to be an entrepreneur. And we are seeing high-quality entrepreneurs. We are seeing a very strong deal flow. We are seeing good companies finally emerging out of tech incubators at the IITs, ISCs, and so on. From an entrepreneur standpoint, this is a great time. The funding ecosystem has also got neatly segmented. You have a clear category of seed funds, angel investors. You have a clear category of Series A investors. You have Series B investors that have started emerging. And then at the late stage for companies that really do well, there's a plethora of capital available through the soft banks, Tencent, the large Chinese companies, the Temasek, and so on. So I think it's a great time to be an investor and an entrepreneur.